Hello, welcome to InDemo, the super demo edition of Chester. It says to press start. Okay, first thing is options, which looks like it's enter. Eh, this was made for Xbox, wasn't it? That's gonna probably be a problem. I like their difficulties. Easy, medium, hard, sad face. I like that it tells you what the difference between each difficulty is. I'm a fan of that. I'm gonna go back to normal. Audio options, those are fine. Auto wall jump, sensitive wall jump. Switch delay. Gameplay, no, that's what I just did. Display key bindings. To adjust these settings, run Chester settings.exe from the uninstall folder. I love that it tells me that there is actually one of those. I know quite a few games nowadays are starting to do this, but knowing for sure that there is one just from the game itself is awesome. I love that. You can, from that install folder, you can see key binding changes, the resolution changes, full screen, stretch screen are the options through that settings. So I'm a big fan of that. That's pretty sweet. What I don't like is not being able to use my mouse to select these options. I can't use my mouse to go to select or whatever. It's a minor complaint. It's not a huge deal. It's just something to me that screams, you know, we forgot the mouse. But that's okay. Now, for those of you wondering, this is a game I found through Reddit. I just saw it posted. I saw a post on there or something a little bit like last week or so. And it looked interesting enough and sounded interesting enough, so I'm going to give it a go. So I am going to play through the tutorial because I've played through this a bit and I've already got some comments here. First things first, it says unlocked bestiary page for small stuff. That down there is actually kind of hard for me to read. I don't know if it's just me or what. Like, I cannot read that. I can barely read it. I have to wait a little bit until it darkens for me to actually be able to read it. Let's go check the sign out. This is the other problem. The sign, you have to actually be, like, exactly in a place for it to be completely... And it's still not completely, I don't know, what's the opposite of transparent? Parent? It's still a little opaque. And that's kind of annoying. Like, if I stop, like, right here, it might just, again, it might just be me. I have a, to me, that's a little hard to read when I'm, like, right here or something, or right here. Like, this is still hard for me to read. That's a little difficult to read. I like, have to be right on it for me to read it perfectly. So, those are two. I am playing, two complaints. I am playing with the controller. You cannot set your key control, your controller keys through the key bindings, which is a little unfortunate. Or if you can, I didn't see it, so I'm using this through X-Pad. Let's get up here. Yeah, see, this is annoying to me. Attack with X or Z key. Explosion. Default controls. Press A or X key twice to double jump. Now I've already figured out this mechanic of wall jumping. It's the same as Super Metroid. If you don't have the... I forget what exactly it's even called. How terrible of me. I'll get back to that in a second. Every character and enemy in Chester has an element. Use the elemental system to your advantage to deal extra damage and take less damage. Careful though, attack with the wrong element and you'll deal less damage and take more. Oh, so that's cool. A little, element ring. What was I saying? Oh, the wall jump. You can't, once you're sliding on the wall, it's not like, say, Mega Man, where you could just hit it again. That's a very bad place to show it. There's a better place here in a second. It's not like Mega Man, where you can just, ooh. Massive frame rate issues. Sorry about that. What I was saying is, it's not like Mega Man where you, or Mega Man X, the CX series at least, where if you're sliding, here's a perfect place to demo it. If you're sliding and you hit jump, oh, never mind, I guess it does. When you're holding the direction towards the wall and you hit jump, it doesn't work. I don't know if that's intentional or not. But if you're just sliding and you're not holding a direction, you hit and jump, you go the other way. And if you hold the opposite direction, you go the other way. You wall jump, so to speak. I don't know if that's intentional or not. I guess it's not quite like a... What the? Okay, well then. See, I cannot read that. That's infuriatingly... That's terrible. That's my first, like, major complaint with the game so far. Along with this. Look out for secret areas. Shit piece collected. What does this thing say? I said sheesh. Hold down. Okay. That's easy enough. One wall sliding, hit A or X key while not pressing against the wall to wall jump. Jackie Chan. Jackie Jan. Okay, so that is intentional. I'm cool with that. Doesn't really matter to me either way. I'm terrible at wall jumping, apparently. There we go. I don't like these big white bars of nothing, either. That's a little... Like, I don't understand why they're there. Maybe they're there for a reason, but, I feel like... You could have just had the level... Oh, maybe that's with the stretch screen. I'm not playing in widescreen. That's probably the issue. Ignore me. Each character has a unique attack. Press Y or A to unleash the fury. Please unleash no furries. How do I know if I've got the special attack, though? Ooh, that's like a weird... So there's definitely different sort of surface textures and stuff. Oops, I got hit by that, I didn't mean to. Okay, what's my... Okay, my special attack slows down time, but I don't think it actually did it? 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2... Oh yeah, okay, it definitely does. I see. Okay. Just a little slow on the slowdown time. That's okay. Gain experience with each character to level up their special. Now you're playing with work and time. How do I get experience? What the? Oh, okay. Okay. That must be health up top, and that small green bar to under that big. Phonograph looking thing, I don't know. Must be, health, or, experience. You are the win level. Press start to continue, you sweetie. Why, thank you, game. That's kind of nice. You have enough stamps to unlock a new character. Press Y or A key to open the shop. Switch categories with left and right. Unlock this character for you to play. So there's more than different characters, and there's a little bit of an RPG element to this game. I don't understand. You have enough stamps for a new character. I'm having trouble actually buying this character. Press Y or A key to open the shop. Deity mode. Unlock the sound test feature. Oh, okay, so there's actually a lot of things here you can... There's quite a bit here. I'm a fan. A new element will be randomly picked for this character. I don't understand what I'm supposed to... Okay, let's go back. Press A key to open the shop. Buy with A. Where... Okay, I do have a problem with this. I don't... Oh, okay, 177 stamps. I see it. I'm just retarded. So this 500 to do that. I must have already bought the character then? That's not very clear. That's kind of, frustrating. And it doesn't appear that I can actually change levels until I get this done. I don't... Alright, I'm gonna stop recording here while I figure this out. Hold on. Okay, for some reason I'm just retarded. No? Like, I have enough stamps for this. I have 177, it says it's 5, but I still can't buy the character. Is this like the end of the demo? I don't... Alright, I'll cut again, I'll mess around for a little bit. I don't know, maybe it was just a bug or something? I reset the game and I bought it fine. So, I don't know if that was a bug or if I'm just stupid and whatever. If it is a bug, that's something that needs to be fixed. That was pretty frustrating. I don't understand what these EM things are. That's okay. Oh, completed on easy, medium, hard. Okay. And then apparently I missed a cupcake. That's okay. I'm okay. Let's skip. Let's go to the next level. You've unlocked a new character. Each has a unique special attack, Y button or A key, that grows stronger as they level up. Switch to your last used character quickly by using the B button or S key. Scroll between all characters using the left and right bumpers or control keys. Characters are randomly assigned an element when unlocked. You can switch characters' elements in the shop. So that's a neat little... Is this what I have? No. I don't... Whoa. You can, like, switch the style of the game? That's kind of cool. This makes things even more impossible, but... Let's go back to the regular... No, actually, this level in general is just really hard for me to see. I wonder if that's intentional. Is this my... There it goes. So let's try Sketch. Who appears to not jump as high and has a little weird thing. Each level has a default style available even if you haven't unlocked it yet. Use LB or right B to scroll through the available styles, which is what I was just doing. That's a little neat little thing they've got. Each style has unique gameplay bonuses. Oh, that's even cooler. I don't understand how the hell I'm actually going to do this in block mode, but... I'm gonna go back to this mode. Ooh, I can aim this? Can I aim that in... Yeah, okay. What about... Oops. I'm already, like, terrible at this. That's okay. You cannot aim this. Okay, so his benefit is that he can actually aim his shots. Ooh, I wonder how you're supposed to get that. I bet you that's a different character. You can pass through a laser unharmed while its color matches your character type. Otherwise, you'll die a painful death. Oh, that's kind of neat. Oop. You have been dead. Oh, crap. I'm a fan of that. Not dying, but the humor in general I'm a fan of. Okay, so let's get through here. My character is fire, so I can go through when it's red. Where does it tell me to go? Oh, these bubbles. I don't know what that is, but we'll take it. Ship pieces collected. So there's definitely a lot of collectibles and stuff here to be had. Oh, okay. When you switch your styles, it tells you what it does. Special attacks consume less ammo, slightly reduced falling speed. Okay, that's kind of interesting. That's even cooler. It tells you, too. You don't have to figure it out for yourself. I prefer that. I would never have noticed that I fall slower. I don't trust these blocks. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Cupcake. You are the win level! It is pretty amusing to me. To space! You have enough stamps for a new character. Okay, let's try this again. So it's A. Oh, by the way, there's element changes you can change for each character, and then there's other things you can get. Guaranteed brain drop, dieting mode, and there, it tells you what you need to do to unlock the items. That's a really, I love that a lot. So let's, I can unlock Bit Chester, or Mr. Chester. Block, Chigami. Let's see what I'm wondering here real quick. Let me take a look-see. Yeah, see, something was wrong. Unless I'm crazy, something was just wrong last time. TacFac? That actually looks like a different character model, so let's try that. Ooh, that thing looks fucky. Or funky. Fucky. Wow. Okay, so let's... Actually, selecting things is a little weird. The keys don't match up. The displayed keys don't quite match up. It's a little weird. Welcome to space! You can tackle the following worlds in any order you desire. Each has a difficulty rating, though it might be best to go in order. Once you beat a world, you'll be able to use that style on any level. Have fun. Don't forget to buy new characters from the shop to help you out. Oh, so you don't even have to do it in any particular order. That's awesome! I'm a pretty big fan of that. Space travel. Oh, is okay, that just tells me I'm in space. But you still have to unlock yourself through the world in an order. That's okay, I'm cool with that. Oh, this is a neat sort of aesthetic. Wait, I have a new character. What does he do? Oh, he's like a lob grenade thing? And what sort of is enemies fire at a slower rate. I'm a fan of that. Oh, crap! Ooh, those things are weak against water, too. So it would be in my best interest to stick to this character for now. Oh, okay, so that must be a brain that dropped there. You've collected a brain. Collect enemy brains to unlock their info in the bestiary. Certain items from the stamp shop and some styles can increase your odds of finding brains. Man, so there's a lot to collect in this game. That definitely gives it replayability. Oh crap. Okay, that's definitely my health. Oh god! Oh god! Nope. Let's switch my character. This isn't a problem with the control scheme, this is me being really bad. Ah, shit. Overall, I have to say, this is a pretty fun little game. It definitely has some problems. Nope. Ah, damn it. It definitely has a couple of problems. It's a little... annoying, that are a little annoying, and sometimes, well, it's annoying. And luckily the signs seem to only be there for the tutorial level, which is good. Excuse me. But the stuff being hard for me to read, I feel like that's a problem. And again, it just might be me. Maybe it is just me. It's very possible. Okay, where the fuck is this frog at? Oh, okay, that's weird. He's, like, not here this time. Oh, whoa, those bounce, too? That's cool. There's, according to the page, there's, 10 characters, the leveling system we've already seen. I don't understand. I'm assuming the leveling system is. I kind of like that. The leveling system is sort of a auto level where it just automatically levels your special. That's what it seems to me. But that's fine. Let's try this other place. Ladder on fire. See, not demo to pass. There's around 50 levels and 8 styles to change the look of the game at will. Four difficulty levels. Hey, that's a weird looking. I gotta say though, this is definitely pretty. It's fun. It's definitely got a lot of replayability to it. That's for sure. Aside from the reading problems I have with it and some of the control issues, not so much that my main control issue being you can't bind your controller. It does show Xbox 360 controller buttons, so I kind of wonder if that's if it automatically plays with that. It does not recognize mine at all. And I don't have a 360 controller. I really wish people would stop assuming everyone did. I hate the 360 controller. And I refuse to get one, so I'm stuck using X-Patter and whatever I can. It's just so I don't have to use that controller. It's kind of infuriating. A lot of major publishers do this as well, so it's definitely not just an indie problem. It's a gaming problem that I find infuriating. The aesthetics are kind of cool, even when you change them. Like he says, it's a different style, but it keeps the same aesthetic. I kind of like that. Let's try changing characters. I feel like the characters are actually varied, judging by their shadows, and it's just the one that I unlocked first isn't all that different. Well, actually, even so, his animations are pretty different. So, I've got to say, I totally recommend trying this demo out and getting the game if it appeals to you. It's definitely a fun little platformer. I feel like. Oh, each character has their own level too. That's cool. Special attack. So much color. I don't know what that does. I don't see a way to see what your special attack does. That's a little unfortunate. Unless there's one in, I'm gonna check and then wrap up this video. Bestiary is B. No, those are credits. No, that's the store. That would select the level. Let's just see here. It does not tell you what the keys are. That's not good. No, I do not want to quit the game, but I'm going to anyway. Yeah, see, that's not what I wanted to do at all. But there you go. This is in demo for Chester. It's actually pretty friggin' reasonable. Right now, it's 10% off as of this video. For $8.99, it's usually $10. I totally think it's worth the $10. There's a lot to it, a lot of replayability, all the difficulties. I'm gonna have to assume that if you do something on a high, actually, you know what? There's an easy way to check. And if you do something on a higher difficulty, it does. it does count as doing it on a lower difficulty, as it should. I know there are very rarely games that don't do that, and that is infuriating. So aside from the display keys and the, I don't know, it's not even a font issue. I think it's just the white on white doesn't really work when your outline is black. And that opaqueness in the tutorial level drives me nuts. So, control issues, a little control issues, decent options. A little bit of text issues. But, generally pretty fun. I'll link in the description to the page to buy it, and I'll also link to the Reddit thread, just in case anyone's kind of interested. Thanks for watching.